Hello, welcome to Outworld, and you're about to see some shocking images. No, no, it's not the Pearl Bird that's going to attack me, it's this thing right here. By the way, I'm using code Sonic. This is the most shocking image players have seen in the game so far. I mean, they're just coming home from a relaxful quest, and then you see the tree is blocking your entrance, and it's on fire, the gates are on fire. So what? No, what happened? Where is everyone? Well, you just failed the Vendaval quest, congratulations. So now we're in the experimental branch of the Steam Outworld game, whatever. And yeah, this should actually be a live update, so the Vendaval quest has been reworked. So when you fail the quest and the... Hey, don't kill the poor pearl bird. Look at them, they want some fresh meat for breakfast. Some chicken. They want a chicken dinner tonight. Anyway, the main goal of the game right now is of course to rescue Vendaval. At least in my game, because I finished all the quests and I just had to come back and see what happens here. So you can actually enter Vendaval right now. Not Vendaval, Sears, I mean. I got distracted by the bird. Run, bird. Oh, he got away? Yeah, he got away. He's a smart bird. So you can actually... Are you okay? Chicken, are you okay? Whoa. That's one lucky chicken. Probably he'll get eaten by the hyenas because he's going into the hyena nest. Oh well. So one way to actually clear Sierzo right now is to enter through the back. Don't do it like I did. You can break your neck if you jump off cliffs. But now you can enter through the back side of the city. You know, that little cave, the Sierzo storage area. And then, as you can see, the troglodytes have been kicked out and they are dead. Well, we are too thirsty to continue right now. But yeah, it's actually a story now. It's part of the game and the quest. As you can see, the troglodytes are basically kicked out by the Vendaval attackers. Oh yeah, this is the Kelvin Great Axe. This is the strongest frost weapon in the game right now, and I'm using the Crimson Plate armor and the Brass Wolf backpack. So let's turn off Code Sonic because we don't need it. Super speed, away. And now begins the really interesting part. Press V to turn on your flashlight. It's a lantern, but I call it a flashlight nonetheless. And now we actually enter the Sierzo storage, and as you can see, there is a little ramp in here. Okay, actually, let's buff up right now, because I don't want to waste time. Also, some survival elixir so the cold doesn't get to us. Some food, of course. I didn't bring any elixirs, because, hey, I don't want super speed. I want to enjoy my time killing them. And before we enter, we'll just read Gep's note, because he's a good guy and he saved us, so we have to save Sierzo right now. Now let's have a drink of his famous potion. Just for good luck. Yeah, let's apply some ice varnish to this thing. Because the damage with this thing is huge right now. 100 frost damage and 48 physical damage. So we should be able to kill all the bandits with no problem. So you run up to here. And as you can see, the troglodytes are dead. I mean, look at this. The Vendaval bandits actually took care of the worst problem Sierzo had. They killed all the troglodytes in the cave. Well, he doesn't have a chance, so let's kick him out of the way. And they are using actually the Old Legion spear, which is very, very long, so this is actually a very good spear. Continue, and don't waste time. Yeah, so basically the little village has been overrun by these bandits. And they hit hard, don't worry about that, they will hit you very, very hard. I just want to show their weapons a bit more, because they'll use the old legion things. Also, you can swap out the brand to actually inflict pain and chill. That will cause the Kelvin Axe to do even more damage, 50% more damage, so that should be about... What was that? 50, 75, that should be it. Well over 200 damage if you use the brand on an enemy and then switch to the Kelvin Greataxe. That will be fun, right? So now we'll actually get to see Siege destroyed in the winter, which is some of the most beautiful images you'll see in the game. Sorry about this, but yeah, imagine that. The burnt Siege actually looks amazing. Because it's not actually burnt, now it's all covered in snow, and it's kind of sad how it looks. So we'll explore this area a bit and see what happened to the residents of Sierzo, just to hammer down the point. As you can see, this guy is dead. And we are just a lone wolf coming back from our journey. As you can see, their ship, the Crimson Pirate ship, has docked in here, in the port, and the lighthouse was somehow cut in half. I don't know, maybe they have cannons and they just blew it out. Rest in peace, lighthouse. So yeah, you lose your house forever if you do it like this. If you fail the quest. Oh, some merchandise over here. Some dead bodies here and there. Where did he go? Oh, he's right there. Okay, so he had the spear. As you can see, some of the areas were completely destroyed. I just like to take a look around the place. You also lose access to the Tsar boss, so that's another reason you should save Vendavel before it gets destroyed, because you lose access to the Tsar boss. I have a beautiful ship, but I don't know how that works. I mean, where are the sails? Is that a massive wind sigil on their ship? Look at this guy, he just wanted to have a bite of fish before he died, and look at his head. It's far enough his head, that's perfect. Oh, he actually dodged that, come on, don't be like that. I worked very hard on this build. So yeah, let's explore more of the village and then we'll go and kill the other guys. Oh, they are so eager to kill me. And yeah, they have a lot of gear, so you can just make a lot of money selling their gear. Well, they sure dodge a lot. Yeah, not dodge, my timing's bad. I haven't really used a lot of access. Okay, let's get up here because I want to kill everyone. And later on I think we'll even find the warlords. Oh, that's a lot of people. Are my buffs holding? Oh, great timing guys. Hit me 5 times before I can retaliate. Well, I guess my boon is also depleted. You know, I have the best timing in the game so far, right? Yeah, I have the best timing in the game. They don't do a lot of damage, but still it will add up if you're not careful. What are you, the Black Knight of? Ah, that's just a prayer claimer. Also, he's a Kazai lieutenant. Fine, I'll eat your jerky and steal your gold. But after I'm done with the village. Sorry about that, you know, I always get caught in buffing. Yeah, I should have blocked, I know, some people will say you should have blocked. Doesn't really matter, they are low level enemies to be honest. Actually not low level, they are mid tier enemies to be more precise. And there are a lot of them. Now, as you can see, this is pretty shocking. As I said, this is the most shocking thing you can see in the game right now. Yep, that man was executed just because you had to, you know, follow that pearl bird or, you know, do that quest before you come back. No, Sierzo is your top priority. There are even some holes in here. Again, I missed it. Okay, that's a good boy. And they even knocked down the dummies, the training dummies, the savages. But it looks like they didn't steal any weapons, so that's cool. That's good. They are all civilized bandits. They only murder and execute people. Oh, hello, Mr. Archer. So he has the mask, the war bow, and some arrows. Nice, and also an iron sword. Was this ornate chest always here? I don't remember. I really don't remember. Was this always here? This is curious. So yeah, you can take a better look at the lighthouse right now. Completely smashed. Again, what were they using? Magic cannons, giants, I don't know, Poseidon, whatever. Yeah, this chest was definitely not here, so I think this only appears if you let Vendaval invade and destroy Sierzo. So far so good. Just want to get every detail of the poor Sierzo village. To get the whole picture. So nothing here, no more dead bodies. Where are all the dead bodies? They threw away the totem? Well, they are really savages. Oh, they died together, they tried to protect everything. So yeah, as you can see, the monument was completely moved and smashed. Well, what's this? Oh, sorry, I'm laughing too much because this is a real tragedy. And you see what happens when you quest too long. This is the first time I actually get to see what happened inside here, so... Like... Oh, this is just too sad. I mean, look at all the images. This is so powerful, and she's the alchemist. She died on her chair. She didn't even have time to, I don't know, cast a spell or drink a potion. Okay, let's check out more of the areas, because I'm getting really fascinated by what happened right here. Well, you didn't see any of that. Nothing to see here, just some bodies burning there. Ah, I hope you're all over 18 years old. Again, I lost my boon. Okay. Don't make me dodge you, I don't like to dodge. Finally. Okay, let's just reapply those buffs, because they're pretty important. And let's have a quick bite to it. You know, this is actually really interesting, because not only did they change the whole Sierzo, they actually added a lot of small elements to the game. For example, you saw that thing over there. The monument was sitting upon it. So I don't know what that symbol is, but that looks important. And you see a lot of gruesome images. Yeah, that was also destroyed over there. The pipes seem to be working perfectly, so this is just for water, I think. Yeah, everything seems to be in order here, because they want to preserve everything. Yeah, they conquered the village, but let's see what... Oh... Is this a destroyed catapult? Destroyed garter. I want to see how the pearl birds are doing. Did they massacre them and eat them? You savages, they did! They did massacre the pearl birds. Just no love for the pearl birds. Sorry about my shoddy combat, about me not paying attention, but I just wanted to see. So where is the black one? Did they take the black one and eat it? And they just killed the white ones? Whoa. And let's see another sad image. You know, this is Burak, the guardian of the gate, the guard keeper of the gate. And he actually died here by the wall. Really fascinating. Sorry about this, will be a very long video just because I want to see what happened to everyone. You know what? I'm getting tired of them. Oh, and this is the Vendaval warlord. This is Croc. Actually, if you get the Vendaval key and the prison key. Oh, so actually this is tied to the quest. So remember, Croc and Burmak, I think that was his name. Yeah, this is one of the original guards. And they have that silver armor. You know, Burmak, the gate guardian, actually had a little problem, a little dispute with Croc. So if you do their quest line, you can actually have Croc killed by some sneaky way. But it looks like Croc got the better of Burmak this time. Well, more dead people all around. So yeah, this is why I think Nine Dot Studio takes so much time to make a new map because they want to make everything perfect and actually add manual things to it. This is not a randomly generated map. This is a map they went through and put dead bodies and other stuff in here. Okay, oh, look at him. Another building I want to check is the inn. Oh, okay, let's go to the inn. I'm really curious about certain things in the game right now. Hey, move out of the way, I'm busy. Is this the inn? I mean, I actually never slept in it. Oh, it got destroyed. Okay, so the entrance got destroyed. So that's one warlord down, two more to go. One of them might be hiding in the city hall. Sorry about the slow pace of the game, but I just had to turn Sonic Code off because I wanted to play this normally. Oh, but there are sure a lot of them. Oh, that's another warlord. Hold on a second, I just have to drink something really quick. Yeah, he's the Crimson Armor guy. He's my lost brother. I don't remember his name. Well, that's sad. I will kill him and I won't remember his name. What a bad time for the boons to just disappear. Okay, let's just kick him while he's down. Yeah, he has my armor, so I want to do basically any damage to him because he's very resistant to frost damage. Actually forgot about him when I made my build. So we'll just have to kill him the hard way. And that's using a lot of skills. Oh, he just stops following you. Well, okay, don't mind me, just let me buff up a little bit. If you remember him, he's actually the captain of the Crimson Pirates or something like that. So yeah, he's responsible for this whole mess practically. Oh, I thought you waited for me. Oh, that did the job. So, oh, he's Rospa the Conqueror. I forgot what I got from him. Oh, so we still get his shield. Yeah, let's wear his shield a bit as a prize. Hit him with your punches. Okay, let's go. Are you okay, Rompa? Let's have the... What saber is that? Oh yeah, he has the Cerulean Saber, which is a legacy item. Okay. Okay, now we know. So one more warlord to go, which is Balira, the Ice Witch. Come on, attack me. Too slow. It feels like you're chopping their heads off. Huh, delicious dinner. Oh, so you actually get some armors besides, and you get a lot of items to sell. So this could be a really useful tactic. I mean, lose Vendavel on purpose. I mean, lose Serge on purpose, then go back when it's destroyed and just get all the loot and sell it for money. Yeah. That's kind of like a bad way to do it, but yeah, I can see some, you know, some things happening with all the loot you can sell from them. Well, anyway, this was an interesting opportunity. I'm glad the developers just showed us the way and let us see what we actually did, because right now this is very gruesome. This is very bad. I mean, they did not... Don't hide. Well, he's actually very good at dodging, but again, they have very poor weapons. I just like to eat all their food. Now let me see, do I have some stamina potions? I do have one. So yeah, they boarded up the place. Hey, what's that texture? Developers, you have to fix that. They broke all the pots. And now let's go to our lighthouse. I mean, we basically saw everything and they did a lot of damage to this place. Yeah, I needed buffs because Balira, I think she's also resistant to frost attacks. Hey, where did you come from? Surprise attack? Oh, come on, don't be like that. Well, he can actually, so he can actually block the whole flash onslaught. Well, that's interesting. Okay, let's just kill them very fast. Don't chop on. Come on, you're missing them. Excuse me. Oh, come on, I wanted to kill her. Now how do I kill her? Well, this is awkward. Oh, are you going to make me go and pick up the bows? Okay, because I'll do it. I'll pick up the bows. Oh. Well, thank you for teasing me. So the great axe is badly damaged. So you get Arcane Robe, which will actually increase your frost damage, astral potions, and some more Vendaval keys. And yeah, that's about it. You lose access to your lighthouse, and you know, you get this very, very sad picture. But one thing I really hope they add, now that I killed all the pirates. A shame he's gone. Now that you kill all the pirates, I really wish you could go up to their ship and steal their ship and make it your base. How cool would that be? Your base gets destroyed by the Vendaval pirates, but then you go back to Sierzo, kill all the bandits, and just, you know, steal their ship, or just make their ship your base. Well, that would be interesting. I just want to check the shoreline more. No, you can't do anything with this thing. I just want to go to the shoreline one more time and see if they manage. Oh, that's burning. If they manage to change something, well, I don't know. No, I think this is everything you can do in here and everything you can see. Well, that was a lot of work for just a couple of pirates. But I didn't come prepared to this fight and I was just missing my attacks, but it was fascinating to see the results of you losing a quest. Yeah, I bet no one will lose the Vendaval quest right now. Bye!